Well, hello everyone. This is Green Bean with RV Theming. And as we drive through downtown Moab right here, I wanted to just talk to you for a few minutes about one of the RV parks they have there in Moab. This one that we'll be discussing is OK RV, and they are an RPI or Resort Parks International site, which is associated with Thousand Trails. Now, one of the reasons that we're still driving here is that I wanted to point out just how far off the beaten path this place actually is. Now, a lot of the other RV parks, they're right there. You can see them from that main boulevard there. So there's a lot of noise and such. Now, OK RV is actually quite a bit outside of that. Not too far or anything like that. I'd say about 3/4 of a mile, maybe half a mile off of the main drag there. And then we'll make the right on their street. But it's nice. It just removes you from all of the Moab hubbub, if you will. And I think that's really one of the first positives that starts to separate OK RV from the other places. And as we try not to hurt this biker right here, we're gonna make the turn and we're gonna head toward OK RV again. They're just about a half mile down the street here on the right hand side. Now, look at this. Now, we're gonna look at their main courtyard here. One of the things I wanna tell you about them is they are a small place, very, very small. But everything is so neat and so clean and so tidy. Now, this little courtyard that they have here, this is where the office is and all that sort of stuff. But as you can see on the map there, they're a small little place. They're not more than 50 spots, I'd say, if even that many. And what we'll do here is we're gonna walk past this little office here. This is the main office on the right. Usually there's someone in there. And they also have a little store in there and all that kind of stuff. Now, yeah, vending machines and such when they're closed, but we're gonna go right in here to the laundry room, and first thing you'll see, what do you see here? It's immaculate. Now, it's small, just like the park itself. I think there were 4 washers and 6 dryers, which I don't know, you should have maybe thought about 5 and 5. One of the little quirky things I noticed, but it's clean. Everything is so clean. And look, we'll take just a little second here to look in one of the restrooms here. There are his and her restrooms, and I'll only be in here for a minute. We don't want to stay too long, but there are 3 showers in there, and look, they have the shampoo and the soap, the body wash there for you if you forget stuff like I do. But just look how clean this place is, and that's really the most important thing. I think we're gonna have to get out of here in a second, but we can't stay in here too long. Thankfully, no one was in there when I went in there, but look, you can tell it's clean. Now, one of the absolute best parts of OK RV, it was 103 degrees the day that I'm filming this, 103 degrees. And what do you see? You see tons of shade. You see mature trees all over the place. This is more so than the other RV parks that are in the area. Sure, they all have some trees, but OK RV seemed to be shady almost throughout the entire park. And look, my dog was out there, totally fine. 103 degrees, probably 70 in the shade. It was beautiful. Another great thing, free cable hookups. That's what we're looking at here, the free cable hookups. Just don't worry about the black tank and stuff like that. But now, another major benefit. When you stay at one of the places closer to downtown Moab, you have all the buildings and stuff kind of blocking the view. At OK RV, one of the things that I just did every morning and every night, I just walked around and looked at this majestic view that they have here. Look, the skies are beautiful this day, but that view right there is incredible. And we'll get a closer look here. There was a, right next door, there was an abandoned or at least closed down horse racing place. They had the whole track there. It was a little bit grown in, but again, there's nobody there. So the benefit being quietness. Oh, I love some good quiet. But, and then there's that mountain range, La Salle maybe, I forget the name of the mountain range. But again, just look at that view. It's gorgeous, nothing blocking your view. And here's a little surprise for you in Utah. They have recycling, which for me is a big one. I don't love the idea of just throwing all the trash in together, and they had recycling, which is not always the case. I think most places that I ran into in this state, they didn't have the recycling option, which I liked. Now, these campers that we're looking at here, these are the rental campers, and they had, I think, 5 or 6 of these guys, and there was only one utilized when I was there. But again, they have them if that's what you should be looking for. And everything's just so cute and quirky here. Look, Doc Holliday Drive, they had a Wild Bill Drive, and I'm trying to show you here they had tents for rent as well. This was their glamping tent, Wild Bill Drive right there, yes. And they also had the teepees. So, and I actually talked to one of the girls who was renting one of them. I asked what it was like in there. She said it was amazing. Two air conditioners, everything was super comfortable. So they have the teepees, the glamping tents, and the RVs. Look, the trees, again, it's important enough to show you twice. And that enables us to really be comfortable during our stay here, so we can actually go about 25 minutes away for the reason that we're in Moab in the first place, because heat kills. That's why the trees are so important. The reason we're there in the first place is for the national parks that are right there. Arches National Park is just about 25 minutes or so away from OKRV. And as you can see here, I'm gonna show you a few things here. This is the walk up to Sandy Beach Arch. Or maybe it's not Sandy Beach, it might just be Sandy Arch, forgive me. But look at this place, the blast we had. This is one of the more obscure arches that we didn't even know about before we got there. You know, the other ones get a lot more press, but look at this place. We stayed there for a good half an hour with the kids running around in the sand, everybody taking pictures, lots of kids laughing and playing. It was the best. Now that's one of the more famous ones, Landscape Arch, where that piece fell off a few years ago, and now they don't let you walk up underneath it for obvious reasons. They don't know when that thing's gonna collapse. But there I am, lose that guy. With my Appalachian Trail t-shirt, that was Tunnel Arch, and here we're walking up to, I believe it is Pine Tree Arch. This place, if you have not been or if you're considering going, it is everything that you've ever hoped or wondered if it was and more. It was mind-blowing to me. I had been there before many years ago for a very brief stint. This one, we stayed there for a few days. We even went back for a sunset over Delicate Arch, which was incredible, and we got to walk back in the dark. That was Balanced Rock. Lots of weird rock formations. And then the other national park, which is right next door, almost another 20 minutes away, Canyonlands, another one. What an amazing, amazing place. If you were thinking about going to this area, do it. My recommendation is solid. It is a beautiful place. It's worth every minute that you'll spend there. Look, more Canyonland views there. And the place that you might want to consider staying is OKRV. Just so you know, I'm not getting paid for this or anything like that. It might sound like it, but I loved this place. I really did. My family had a great time, and we just were blown away with how clean it was, how shady it was, and how much you're gonna like it. And that's it. OKRV Park, in my opinion, the best in Moab.